Greetings, Earthlings. It is I, the Crafting DM. Today, we will take a look at some water effects.
If you like what you see on my channel, please go ahead and like and subscribe. And also, you can check me out on Instagram at TheCraftingDM. All right, let's take a look.
Alright, jumping right in. Once I had all the bits glued to the foam base of my dungeon room, prior to painting, I used whatever glue I had lying around to seal up the seams to prevent resin from leaking through later on. After I felt pretty comfortable that all the seams were sealed up well, I primed the whole piece with a coat of Apple Barrel's black paint mixed with a fair amount of water. The watery mixture really helps the paint work its way into all the nooks and crannies. You don't have to do a spectacular job here, since it will mostly be covered up by gray layers later on. But do make sure you get into all the shadowy areas. The parts that still look wet are spots where I touched up the black undercoat with acrylic ink. Acrylic ink is very watery and covers recessed areas very well.
Next, I hit all of the stone areas with Apple Barrel's pewter gray. I use this in most of my builds so that all of my terrain is modular and blends together well. When painting the gray layers onto the Herstart's fieldstone bits, I make sure to use a dry paintbrush. This keeps the paint thick, so the gray layers stay higher up and prevents any unwanted gray from covering up any black paint in the recessed areas. Next, I gave the whole piece a once-over dry brushing with Apple Barrel's Granite Gray. Again, make sure that you're using a completely dry brush for this step. To prevent any big globs, it helps to paint the brush out on a paper towel before you touch it to the stone. After I was satisfied with the way the stone looked, I turned my attention to the areas that would be underwater. I started by painting a base layer of Apple Barrel's Burnt Umber along the floor of the moat. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect, since we will be adding another paint layer of marsh green and then filling the area with resin. Using Apple Barrel's marsh green, I dotted the entire boat area to create an algae effect. This will show through very nicely once the resin is poured over. Once the paint had completely dried, I sprayed the entire piece with Mod Podge Clear Acrylic Sealer. Next, I cut a few clippings from some fake plants that I purchased at IKEA to use as flora accents throughout the piece. Using a bamboo skewer, I carefully punctured a guiding hole in the foam along the moat areas where I intended to place the plants. I placed a bit of Aileen's tacky glue on the stems and secured the plants in each hole. Don't worry so much if they seem loose. Once the resin fully cures, they will be very well anchored. For this project, I used an easy cast resin kit, which you can pick up for a very reasonable price on Amazon. You can also use a cheap acrylic water kit from the floral section at Walmart to achieve a very similar effect. Prior to measuring, I placed both the resin and the hardening agent on a sunny windowsill to warm. You can also use a bowl of warm water. You want the temperature to be lukewarm and not hot. This is important because if your resin is too hot or too cold, it will become bubbly during the curing process. Sometimes I intentionally allow the bubbles, for example, if I'm making acid terrain tiles or a bubbling swamp, but for this build I wanted to avoid excess bubbling as much as possible. Next, I marked two plastic cups to equally measure the resin and hardening agent. It is important that you use equal parts to get a proper cure. After you have your resin and hardening agent measured into equal parts, take your time to thoroughly mix them together until they are nice and clear. This is an important step. Failure to thoroughly mix the two together will result in an imperfect cure. Once it was mixed together, I used Citadel's Athonian Camo Shade to tint the mixture. Most paints, shades, or inks will work, so experiment and see what works for you and your project. Make sure to pour the resin across your piece slowly and evenly, allowing time for the liquid to spread and settle. It is important to do a nice high pour to allow air bubbles that are suspended in the mixture time to escape. This will help prevent unwanted bubbling during the cure. Once your resin is in place, cover the piece to prevent dust or debris from getting stuck in your pour and let it cure for a day or two. All in all, I'm pretty happy with the way this piece turned out. You can use the same technique to create all sorts of liquid effects for your dungeon rooms. Water effects provide your dungeon rooms with unique environmental hazards and obstacles that can help you bring complexity to your tabletop setups. All right, that's all for today. Until next time.